Hello, my fellow Kenyans. I'm Gakonga, the coach and the pioneer of Vision Total Football Kenya. Habari zenu wa Kenya wenzangu. Wa Kenya wenzangu, nataka kuanza hapa. Saa hii, ninataka kuzungumza kuhusu ile Odibet. The Odibet sponsorship deal that FKF county leagues were given by this betting company. My fellow Kenyans, because our football has failed to grow, because our football is equal to nothing, because our football has no economic value, when we get a very, very small deal that is equal to nothing, we say at least it is something. Yes, I agree, it is something. But for how long are we going to keep saying everything we get given, we say at least is something? Why did it has to get there that we have nothing, so that when we get something, we say at least it is something? My fellow Kenyans, we need to think, we need to wake up, we need to see the value of our football. But let us go into figures, my fellow Kenyans. You know, county leagues, each county has about 32 county leagues. 38 games to play. So each county, a county team will have about 38 games to play. That means that these leagues, they will be, when the money is divided, this 42 million per year, when it's divided into all leagues in the counties, each county will walk away with less than a million, my fellow Kenyans. When that money is then divided into clubs, each club will walk away with less than 42,000 Kenya shilling per year. And remember this, one club has to play at least 38 games. So if you think about it, this 42,000 Kenya shilling, it is not even enough to pay a referee for a season, yeah, to officiate games that the clubs have to play. Even if you pay a referee just 1,000 Kenya shilling per match, and these clubs have to play 38 games. So that means from 42,000, the club is only left with 3,000 Kenya shilling. My fellow Kenyans, what type of football is this? Because our football is full of shenanigans. Our football has not grown. You know, county leagues, yeah, it is only 4 steps away to becoming a Kenya Premier League clubs. Yeah, if your club play at county level, yeah, you only have Division 1, Division 2, National Super League, and then the Kenya Premier League, you are in there. And then you are celebrating and saying 42,000 Kenya shilling per year at least is something, knowing that in only 4 years you could be playing at Kenya Premier League. Our football has no money. Our football economy has failed to grow. Our football governance is shit. Our football management is nothing. My fellow Kenyans, I'm starting to question myself. Is this bet, yeah, is this Odibet deal related to FKF elections? Ask me why I'm asking this, because I'm a critical thinker. When I see something, I think of something and I look into the, I actually pay attention to small details. I want to ask you this. Why is the timing so right? Because at this point in time, we have shambles in FKF election. Suddenly, we have this deal and we know that county leagues, yeah, and clubs participating at the county level, they are going to be crucial when it comes to voting, at least the chairman, yeah, at the branch level. So what I see here, why is FKF trying to legitimize its existence? Why is FKF trying to show that at least at this point in time, we are doing something, we are doing something? And the reason why I say this, how does FKF head office, yeah, really relates to the county leagues and the county clubs, my fellow Kenyans? Because those clubs there, they should be dealing with their own issues, they should be dealing with their own you know, leagues, their own sponsorship deal. How then do officials from FKF, the head office officials, yeah, get involved in this sponsorship deal? This is the question I want answered. This is the question I want to ask. On the other hand, we are being told three counties cannot participate in FKF election. That is Lamu, Tana River, I think there's one more county, Samburu, that cannot be involved in FKF elections. Why? They have no football. There's no football in that county, in those counties. There's not enough teams in those counties. That is what we are being told. So they will not participate in FKF election if election is to be done again. Because you know the election that was done last month was cancelled by the sports disputes tribunal. So instead of FKF head office focusing on real issues of football, go to these counties that has no football and start working out what are the issues, why is there no football, and yet FKF has been in existence for so long. In fact, the current president Nick Mwendwa has been in office for 4 years, and yet FKF office can turn around and tell Kenyans there's no football in these three counties. Let us stop joking with Kenyans. Let us stop joking with the government. Let us stop joking with people's life. And now here you hear, oh, we have this multi-million deal. It is going to mean a lot to grassroots football and grassroots talent and raw untapped talents. This is shenanigans. Kenyans, we need to wake up. We need to do the right things and save our football. How is clubs playing at a county level are being called the real grassroots clubs? So what are we going to call the village teams? Unborn teams or unborn talent? Please, if we don't know if we don't know exactly about football, let us do some research. Let us understand football. County level football is not that much of a grassroots, to be honest. So when we talk of grassroots football, let us analyze and ask ourselves, what does it mean, real grassroots football? These issues of getting little money here from sponsors and then we go out partying. Oh, this is money. I said the same thing when Betika sponsored the National Super League, and I said it is 62,000 Kenya shilling per club per year. Yeah. What can a club do with that amount of money, my fellow Kenyans? Yeah, this is what I'm saying. Our football require real genius. Our football require real focus. Yeah, because if I can tell you today, clubs that play at what you'd call the county level, not county level, level five of Kenyan football. Yeah, you know that's where we are going with this county football. That is level six. Clubs that are playing at level five in England, it is Akina Bromley Town FC, Poole Town FC. These are level five clubs that even Kenyans are betting for when these clubs are playing. And now we come here, we have the county level, which is level six, and we keep saying, oh, this is a good deal, 42,000 Kenya shilling. Let us think about it. Level seven England football, the sponsorship they have, it is level seven. Kenya hata hatuna level seven, inaishia level six hapo kwa county. But let me tell you, level eight leagues in here in England, their sponsorship deal is over 10 billion Kenya shilling. That is title sponsorship for clubs in level eight. So what do we mean when we say our clubs at county level, 42,000 shilling per year, yeah, is a good deal, or it is something at least for a whole year. My fellow Kenyans, we need to wake up. Tunachezewa game usiku na mchana. Deals are done in the middle of the night. They are announced in the daytime, and we go out celebrating. We need to be critical thinkers. We need to think about our economy. We need to think our value as Kenyans. We need to think about our value as football players. What are you worth? Ikiwa utapewa shilingi tano useme at least is something. My fellow Kenyans, I want to ask FKF to stop joking with Kenyans. Stop joking with the Kenyan talents. Stop joking with Kenyan football players, my fellow Kenyans. And this issue of every single day a deal is announced, and then we don't know whatever happened to it. We had Bamba, yeah, the company that the TV company that was sponsoring Super League. They just exited. I said again, we had a company called Mafro that was paraded in 2017 by FKF on our TVs, Kenyan TV, saying that we now have a deal for Harambee Stars kit sponsorship. What happened to this Mafro company? It just disappeared. I don't even know what happened. The deal never went on. So we have seen this enough of announcements, an announcement that eventually just disappears into the thin air. So my fellow Kenyans, for me, there is no celebration. I want to see Kenyan football being proper and being valued and being given good value when it comes to sponsorship deal. I am not in that class of saying at least it's something. I'm not jumping in that boat and saying at least it's something. I want to see our football become commercially viable. I want to see our football players, wherever they are playing, starting their football career proper. I want to see grassroots football benefiting. I said it before, when you see sponsors coming to tell us at least we have thought of grassroots football, at least we have thought of nurturing football in Kenya, that is a lie. Betting company are business people. What they have seen, yeah, it is something that is worth sponsoring. But what we need to ask ourselves, is it for us or is it for them? If it's for them, why can't we grow something so that when they come, we get proper money? That is the question we must ask ourselves. All these companies are business companies. What they see, it is a chance to exploit. And for us, we just say that is something. My fellow Kenyans, let us do critical thinking. Tuache huu ujinga wa kila siku. I leave you in peace. I'm gone.